Rufus Bousquet recalls that he's on record as having said, when the United Workers' Party was in government, that it was unreasonable to pay civil servants an unprecedented 14% wage hike. The money, amounting to $25 million, was disbursed in October 2008. Mr. Bousquet, then foreign minister, recalls that his position was that, left to himself, he would not have paid the money and was in favor of going back to the polls to let the country decide. Against that backdrop, the former MP for Choiseul says he cannot in good conscience now say that it's reasonable for civil servants to expect a 15% wage hike this time around.
Anybody who observes what is going on globally, we live in an era of retrenchment, we live in an era of pay cuts, we live in an era of austerity, and this is going on in countries far more developed, while many of them, their whole fiscal situation is considerably worse than that of St. Lucia. But we're sitting on the edge of a cliff, and it wouldn't take very much to tip us over.
According to Mr. Bousquet, the wage hike being requested by public service unions is not within the realm of what the country can tolerate. That fact, he says, has to be recognized and digested.
What I do believe, though, is that rather than simply paint a picture of how difficult things are, the Prime Minister and his government should at this point in time be presenting a plan of action to take St. Lucia out of the situation that it's in and to be able to give people the hope that going forward, adjustments can be made which would be beneficial to them. I think that is the sort of thing that people would be a lot more reasonable in accepting. But when we give an entire doomsday scenario, it is one which obviously will create a situation where people will lose hope and believe that perhaps nothing could be forthcoming now or even in the future. And I don't think it is something that is unavoidable.
Mr. Bousquet says he believes St. Lucia can move forward, and there are a number of things that can be done to take the country out of what he called the deep economic malaise that it is facing. He disclosed that he has made several requests to speak with the Prime Minister and members of his cabinet to present some of the ideas and the things that the former government worked on at taxpayers' expense. But according to Mr. Bousquet, there are no takers after more than a year. He says the Prime Minister did indicate that he was very busy, and early in the new year he would sit and discuss those ideas. However, the former foreign minister says he has been there and understands the politics and knows that when a politician in office does not want to see someone, he can be very busy. For the DBS News World, Pete Ninval reporting.